A Manila court orders the arrest of Peter Jomel Bicoya Vincula after he failed to attend his arraignment Wednesday. This is in connection with the perjury case filed against Vincula by former senatorial candidates Chel Jocno and Erin Tanyada, along with former Supreme Court spokesperson Theodore Te. The lawyers accuse Vincula of falsely linking them to a supposed plot to oust President Duterte. Vincula is the hooded figure that appeared in viral videos linking President Duterte's family to the narcotics trade.
The Philippine Supreme Court says President Duterte does not have unbridled authority to withdraw from treaties, even as it junked petitions questioning President Duterte's withdrawal from the International Criminal Court. This was the court's conclusion in a March ruling that was released only this Wednesday. The court junked the petitions filed by minority senators, the Philippine Coalition for the ICC, and the Integrated Bar of the Philippines. It said they did not have the legal standing to challenge Duterte's move. It also declared the petitions moot since the Philippines has completed the requisite acts of withdrawal and there's nothing in the Rome Statute that allows a state party to the treaty to reverse it. Even so, the court laid down guidelines for future cases. The president, it said, has leeway in withdrawing from agreements he or she determines to be contrary to the Constitution or Philippine laws, but that cannot be unilaterally done if agreements were entered into based on a law passed by Congress or if the Senate requires its concurrence as a condition for withdrawal.
In other news, there will be no Go Duterte tandem in the 2022 national elections. That's according to presidential spokesperson Harry Roque. He also belied claims President Rodrigo Duterte only wants to run for vice president so that it will be easier to replace his longtime aide Senator Bongo if they both win.
Sasabihin ko pong tama yan kung close si Congressman Lagman kay Presidente. Alam ko po walang connection at all si Congressman Lagman, so wala pong katunayan yan.
The camp of Vice President Leni Robredo hits back at Malacanang's claims she resigned from President Rodrigo Duterte's cabinet in 2016 to become the leader of the opposition. Robredo's spokesman points out it was the Duterte administration that prevented her from fulfilling her functions as head of the government's Housing and Urban Development Coordinating Council. Robredo was supposedly barred from attending cabinet meetings in December 2016. Robredo's resignation was brought up after her interview with ANC's After the Fact, where she said she wouldn't treat Duterte the way he treated her should their roles be reversed.
Opposition coalition Isambayan looking for Senate candidates who are not enablers of President Duterte. Isambayan co-convener Howard Calleja says it is important to know where a potential candidate stands on issues such as extrajudicial killings under the administration's drug war. But he clarifies passing laws that are in favor of Duterte does not mean someone is an enabler. Isambayan is eyeing 28 potential candidates for the 12 Senate seats.
Marami po dyan bumoto ng anti-terror law. No, they voted yes for the anti-terror law. Hindi ho naman ibig sabihin kung ikaw ay bumoto ng yes, automatic ka namin na ipoconsider. We will of course sit down and talk and discuss. Kasi pwede naman umuo kayo pero baka naman meron naman mga payag naman kayo na pwede naman may mga amyendahan sa batas, for example. So, titignan po natin. At saka, syempre, you know, nasa proseso po yan. We go through the process. We always give them the opportunity to defend themselves. Hindi po kami kukuha ng magbubudot-budot dance lang, magpapatawa, o magbibigay ng jacket, o kaya magpapa-swab test na sarili niya ang gagamitin na hindi man siya gagamit ng kahit na anong doktor at sasabihin niya, he can do a swab test by himself. No, so hindi ho kami gagawa niya. It's a very serious position, and it's a position that should be given to not only qualified but really those that have a heart for public service.
Meanwhile, detained opposition Senator Laila De Lima has announced she will seek re-election in 2022. Senator Rizza Ontiveros, who will also seek a second term, welcomed her ally's announcement.